I get it. You are busy. You've got a lot on your plate. You've got so many things to do. And when you hear someone say, oh, you know, you have to take time for self-care. You have to prioritize yourself. You have to put yourself on your to-do list. That probably sounds a bit frustrating because you're like, I know I need to do all these things. I know that I need to take better care of myself. I know that my life would feel better if I had more energy and if I was able to get my body to feel stronger and to sleep better and to eat better, all of these things. I know that you know all these things. And I also know that it's hard to actually do the things that you know that you should do for better health, better happiness, for more fulfillment and success in your life. So how do we create the space? How do we create the time? How do we do the things that allow it? Well, the reality is it's not really a time management thing. It actually is more of a priority management. And I've talked about this before of putting yourself on your to-do list, but there are even simpler ways that you can create little pockets, micro moments of self-care that can allow you to experience the benefits of maybe doing a full-on spa day or whatever it is within the confines of your busy day and schedule. Because I get it. You don't have the luxury all the time to take time off to do the things that you want to do solely for yourself because you have roles, you have responsibilities, you have relationships that really depend on you. And maybe you don't feel that you have the support or you don't have the ability to delegate or automate or eliminate certain things off your plate. So how do we figure it out? How do we make it work? How do we help you take care of yourself? Well, I'm glad you asked. Micro moments is something that every woman can put into their day, something that every woman can find the time, even when they feel like they don't have it. And I think it starts first with understanding that self-care truly is the intentional practice of tending to your needs. And the more comfortable you get with understanding what your needs are and understanding what really can support you in that moment, and then giving yourself that thing or some variation of that thing, that's when you start to build the muscle of self-care. And one of my favorite things to do is savor three sips. This is something that I find is really helpful for women who are on the go all the time. Savor three sips means that no matter what beverage you consume in the morning, in the afternoon, dinner, whatever it is, that you make the commitment to savor the first three sips. I'm telling you, it's genius for many different reasons. Because here's the thing, I've made this beautiful cup of coffee and typically I'll make it and I will sit down and I sit actually right in this chair, especially if I'm here in LA, and I savor it and I take my time. And right now I'm tasting the notes of caramel. I'm tasting the vanilla from my almond milk. I'm feeling the warmth of the cup. I am smelling the aroma. I'm actually like the taste of the coffee. It's actually pleasant. It's something that I thoroughly enjoy. I mean, even the look of it, it has this like beautiful foam, a little bit of cinnamon dusted on top. It's in a beautiful cup. I'm romanticizing my coffee experience. I may not have 30 minutes to, you know, luxuriously sit at a cafe and enjoy my coffee, but I can enjoy the first few sips. I can enjoy that moment. That probably takes, what, 3 minutes to enjoy three sips of coffee in peace? That's huge. That's important. That is something that you can do always. I often find with my clients, they will take the coffee, make it as they're on the phone or reading an email or rushing out the door, and they're not really enjoying the coffee. It's just, one, it's just kind of like a habit at this point, coffee. Two, it's getting the caffeine in the body because they need that jolt because they haven't slept well and they're running off fumes. And coffee actually is a really great, like, luxurious self-care moment if you make it. So taking that time just to savor your first few sips. Uninterrupted, giving you a chance to just slow down and connect with yourself, with your senses, before you open the email, before you do whatever. I've even had clients that I'll say, okay, like really short on time. I'm like, okay, as you're making the coffee, like take your first three sips standing in that spot before you walk somewhere else and do something else. It's small, but it makes a huge difference. Another thing that I love to do is take three deep breaths before I get out of the shower. So when I'm in the shower, before I turn the water off, I'll finish doing everything and I will take some time and just take three deep breaths. Big inhales in through the nose, filling up the belly, and then a deep exhale out through my mouth. And as I take those inhales and exhales, I'm feeling the water on my skin. I'm feeling the warmth. I'm feeling my body just take a moment for itself. I might even inhale in like a word or a mantra or something that I need or an affirmation for the day. And just take that moment. Again, it's three deep inhales and exhales. And I know that you might be rushing through your day, but you can afford that 60 seconds to take a deep inhale and exhale three times in the shower before turning off the water and starting your day. It's important, and it's very easy to do, and it's easy not to do. And that's where I think people get stuck with self-care and things like that. It's like they think these little moments don't count, but they add up. Another thing that I do is, and this is actually a newer kind of micro moment of self-care that I have done. And that is when I take a bite of my food, I put the fork down. Now, I got this from a book that I'm reading, and I can't remember the name of it, but it's a book, and it talks about slowing down in a fast world. And I noticed for myself and actually like my partner, like when we were eating, I started to notice how we were eating our meals. And it was interesting because as we are like putting the food in our mouth, we are already ready creating the next perfect bite. And so we're chewing our food and we're preparing for the next bite. And it's almost like take a moment to appreciate the bite that you just created. Take a moment to slow down, to properly chew your food, to taste all of the flavors, to feel it in your mouth. We don't chew our food enough, actually, which causes a lot of digestive issues. So it's also like taking the time to give your body, you know, more support in the digestive process. And it's so interesting what we notice by doing that simple thing of putting the fork down between bites. We appreciate the food more. We're appreciating the company more. And we were eating less, but actually getting full because we were giving our body time to really know that we were getting full instead of just cramming food in our mouth to get to the next thing. And I now do it when I'm by myself when I eat. I'll sit down, I'll look out the window, I won't look at a phone. I'll just simply be. And that is something that you can easily do as well. The goal isn't to add more to your plate. The goal isn't to make your life more stressful by adding self-care and making self-care feel like a chore. But it's really about creating practices that allow self-care to be something that truly is beneficial for you. Because I know, for example, when I'm really, really stressed out and really going through it, that a massage typically doesn't help me. Going to the spa doesn't help me. Now, I'm sure it does for other people, but for me, because I am so stressed out that when I go to the spa or I go to the massage, I have such a hard time disconnecting from the stress that got me into the massage, you know, table or into the spa, that it's not enjoyable for me. I'm tense. I'm thinking about other things. It's hard for me to disengage. But when I start incorporating these micro moments of self-care into my day and just finding moments to take a deep breath or to savor something that I'm eating or to look out of a window and just gaze outside for 5 minutes, or to make the conscious decision to close my laptop in between meetings to give my eyes a rest, or to, you know, just stop every now and then and check in with myself and say, what do I need right now? Right before this, I was like, gonna film this video. And I thought to myself, what do I need? I was like, actually, I want a cup of coffee. I actually want to have that kind of experience. So right before I made my coffee, I sat down, I enjoyed my first three sips. And then I pressed play. And then I got back to work and I feel more grounded. I feel more connected. I feel more relaxed. And also, I feel more supported. Like, I trust that I know how to support myself, even in these small moments. And that's my kind of challenge to you. Where can you create micro moments of self-care throughout the day? So that way, you actually are giving yourself what you need. You're practicing self-care, but you're doing it in a way that's easy to implement. It's more accessible. It doesn't require a lot. But you'd be surprised. A little goes a long way. It adds up over time. So whether it's savoring the first three sips, whether it's taking three deep breaths in the shower before you get out and start your day, maybe it's putting the fork down in between bites. Take one of those three or create your own. Or maybe you're doing things you don't even realize that you're doing. And start to be more intentional about them and bringing them into the fold of your day. It all matters. It all adds up. And this was just a very quick kind of moment that I wanted to share with you to see that self-care can be easy, it can be simple, and it's something that you can definitely start to implement into your daily life. So here's to micro moments of self-care, because you deserve it. Practicing self-care doesn't have to feel selfish or you don't feel guilty. It can be as easy as taking three deep breaths or savoring three sips of your favorite cup of coffee.